Good morning and welcome to the day 3 of our 21-day prayer and devotion. With me, I want to thank you, all of you, for joining us over the last 2 days. Our devotions, many of you have been giving a great feedback, and I'm glad God is speaking to you, to all of you, through these devotions. We started off talking about how God is inviting us into a new season in our lives, and how He challenges us to arise from our inactivity and come away with Him in order for us to experience the new spring that He's bringing forth into our lives. Well, while we are entering into the new season, He has already instilled some wonderful new things for our lives. That these new things are never going to be like what we have experienced in the past. This morning, yesterday morning, we looked at how God speaks through Isaiah and telling us that while we remember what had happened in the past, we must forget all that and focus on what is ahead of us. Because what God is about to do in our lives, the new thing, is going to be afresh, is going to be new, absolutely brand new. We tend to make old experiences as a reference point for the future, but God teaches us that our reference point must be God, not our old memories, if we need to move forward in the future. Well, today we're going to look at another aspect of this new season. Paul, writing to Timothy in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 22, he makes a very interesting and a very important statement to Timothy. Flee from the evil desires of youth and pursue righteousness, faith and love and peace, along with those who call on the Lord out of a pure heart. There are three words that stood out for me in those in that passage, and out of that I just want to teach a small thought for you to think through today. Have you ever shared your toothbrush with somebody? I'm absolutely sure none of us, even at the thought of sharing our toothbrush with somebody else, we cringe at it, right? Like, you know, that thought itself is not something that we like. And we will never consider using our toothbrush, not only just sharing, but also use it for something else other than brushing our teeth, right? You don't use your toothbrush to clean something else. You don't use your toothbrush to clean your sink or commode or a glass or anything. You just use it for your teeth. It's set apart. It's something that is only for one specific task, not to be shared, one purpose alone. That's what Paul was trying to talk to Timothy, and he's saying, when he says, have a pure heart, he's actually saying, you are set apart. You are a holy person. That's how we must live our lives. Specifically, when we know that we are the followers of Christ, the Word of God tells us that we are to be holy. This means that He wants our life to be set apart so that He can use our lives. That our lives are set apart for His use only. In order for that to happen, we must do two things. Now, these two things, you can't say, I will do one and not do the other one. You must do both the things. The first thing he says, and right in the beginning, is the word that he used, flee, run away, he says. Run away from things that stimulate wrong desires within you. Which are things, that are contrary to what Jesus intends for us to think or do. Flee from youthful lusts, he says. Anything that can make us unclean, that's what it means. So, in order for us to experience new things in the new season, we must flee from anything that is contradictory to the Word of God, that is contradictory to the character that God is trying to build within us. Anything that stirs up to do wrong, anything that stirs us up to do things with wrong motivation, flee from them, wrong desires. But then he also says, not just flee, but also pursue. So just like yesterday, he asks us to remember and forget. Today, the Word of God tells us, flee from certain things, but pursue something else. What does he want us to pursue? He asks us to pursue righteous living. He asked us to pursue faithfulness. He asked us to pursue love and peace. You see, these are, in fact, the gift of the Holy Spirit. Well, we call them the fruit of the Holy Spirit. In Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 23, when we read that, the same idea is expressed in a different word, different phrasing. We are to put off the works of the flesh aside, then follow after the Holy Spirit to allow Him to develop within us the fruit of the Spirit. As simple as that. So flee from wrong desires in order to experience new things, but in order to fully experience the new things, pursue righteousness, peace, faithfulness, and love. So today, let us ask God, along with the psalmist David, create in me a clean heart, O Lord. Renew a right spirit within me. In Psalm 51, verses 10, that was the prayer of David. And that's a prayer we must do today. You see, in order for us to enjoy the new things that God is doing in the new season, we must have a new heart. The old heart with wrong desires cannot really value what God is doing within us today, the new thing. We tend to undervalue, underappreciate what God is doing if our heart is not at the right place. That's why in order for us to understand the beauty of what God is doing within us, we must have the right heart, pure heart. So let us ask the Holy Spirit to search us, reveal anything that is in our lives that is contradictory to this word of God and does not please Him. Then admit our wrongs to Him and be cleansed by the Holy Spirit, by the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. 1 John chapter 1 verses 9 tells us that if we confess our sins, He is faithful to forgive us of our sins and also cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So reflect on this question as we close this devotion this morning. What are the things around you that are stirring up wrong desires within you? What kind of people around you that are stirring up wrong ideas inside you? Determine to put those things away today. If you don't know how to do that, ask God to give you wisdom to do that today. Because a new season, a new thing is awaiting you. You will not be able to fully enjoy it, fully appreciate it, if you don't have a new heart. And so ask God to help you and give you wisdom to deal with this. May the Lord help you as you search within your heart and seek for a new heart today. God bless you.